Hi friends, this is Rajshekhar Reddy. Friends, in this video, we will develop a small Spring Web MVC application. First, I will use with XML, then next video, I will remove that XML file and I will replace with annotations. In order to work with Spring Web MVC, first we need to add some jar files. What the jar files we need to add is, first we need to add that Spring Web MVC. Spring Web MVC Maven dependency we need to add in the pom.xml XML file. Similarly, we need to add one more dependency, that is nothing but servlet type from api.jar also we need to add. That dependency also we need to add in the pom.xml XML file. These are the main two jar files in order to work with Spring Web MVC. After that, I want to display, I will take one JSP file and I want to print a small hi message. For that, first I am trying to open my Eclipse. After that, I want to create a new Maven project. For that, just right click, a new project, then search for Maven project. Maven project, after that, just click on next. After that, click on next. In the catalog, select internal so that we will get only few projects. In the down, when you scroll down, you can get here architect type web app, just web app 1.0, just select it, just click on next. After that, in the group ID, give your package name. In my case, I am giving as tk.learn2success. In the artifact ID, give your project name. I am giving my project name as Spring Web MVC. I am giving. After the MVC XML, I am giving. After that, just click on finish. It takes some time. After that, the project structure will be created. In the status bar, you can see that it is trying to download all the required folder structures from the central repository. It takes some time. After that, I am trying to open that. I am trying to expand my project. Just expand it. Here I can see there are lot of folders are created. Just open that pom.xml file. To XML tab. Here we need to add the dependencies. I will increase the font size so that we can see clearly. Font, colors and font, just search for here font, text font, edit, bold, I will use 12, just click on OK. After that, apply and close. OK. Here we need to add the dependencies, required dependencies. Just go to Google and search for Spring Web MVC Maven dependency. Just open this first Maven repository. Just you can select any version. Here I am selecting the latest version, that is nothing but 5.0.5. Just copy this dependency. Just go to pom.xml file. In the dependency tag, we need to add, under dependency tag, we need to paste that dependency. After that, just save it. When you click on save, automatically it is downloading the required jar files from the central repository to our local repository. Similarly, we need to add one more jar file, that is one more dependency, that is nothing but servlet-api 3.1 Maven dependency. You can select this one and add this dependency. Go to pom.xml file. In the dependency, just paste it. Just after that, save it. After that, just select all, Ctrl Shift F to format the text. After that, save it. Okay. We are ready with all the required jar files also. Just check it out. Just go to Java resources. expand libraries. In the Maven dependencies, you can see all the jar files are downloaded. But by default, the Maven will use Java 1.5 version. I don't want Java Maven to use 1.5 version, so that's why I want to use Java 1.8 version. So that's why we need to add one compiler plugin, Maven compiler plugin. I will search for Java compiler Maven plugin. Just to open this first link, just copy this properties tag. We need to paste under the root tag. Then root tag nothing, that is nothing but project. Just go to pom.xml file. You can paste anywhere. Just here. Just I am trying to paste it. Just upload. Just save it. It is downloaded, but it is our Java version is not changed. So what we need to do? Just select the project. Just right click. Maven update project, just select force update, just click on OK. Here you can see that Java 1.0, it is changed our Java version. Java 1.8 are using. Okay, we are ready with all the dependencies. After that, we need to have one web.xml file. Why? Because it is a web based application. No, just to go to, don't touch here src folder, just go to deployment, deployed resources, go to web app, inside web app you can see the web.xml file. In the web.xml file we need to configure that that is nothing but servlet context, dispatches servlet we need to configure, which is responsible to control all the containers. Just go to source. Meanwhile, first we need to have one Spring Bean configuration file. I want to place it in the web-inf folder itself. Just select the folder, right click, new other. I want Spring Bean configuration file. Spring Bean configuration file, just click on next. I want to place here itself. First I don't want, why? Because when we configure this dispatches servlet, we will give one name. That file name should be, we will use for creating that Spring Bean configuration file. So that's why I am not creating first. First I want to configure that dispatches servlet. So that's why I am selecting here. First we need to one more tag, that is nothing but context config. Context loader listener we need to configure. Just when you go typing that one on the control space and enter, it will get this one. But it is asking the web.xml location, that is Spring Bean configuration location. We will wait. First, I want to create that, configure that dispatcher servlet also. What I am, just I am trying to type that dispatcher servlet. Dispatcher servlet. Just control space, just click on enter. It automatically the code will be generated. I don't want this init param, just remove this line. I am writing load on startup. Okay, after that here I want to change the name to Spring. Servlet name I want to give as Spring. Copy this one, give the in the servlet mapping tag also the same Spring. In the URL pattern I want to give only slash. Okay, after that their context config location, no, first slash web-inf folder slash give the Spring Bean configuration file name. We want to give the Spring Bean configuration file name, but in order to create the, there is one rule available. In order to the name, we cannot decide, the name should be the servlet name configured in the web.xml file, iPhone servlet.xml file we need to give. You can give any servlet name here, but the name after servlet-xml file mandatory. For that, what I am trying just to give select web-inf new other search for Spring Bean configuration file name. Spring Bean configuration file name, after that click on next. Give it as the servlet name will be servlet name is Spring iPhone servlet.xml. Mandatory, the Spring Bean configuration must end with iPhone servlet.xml file. After that, just click on next. Next, click on finish. Click on finish, okay. Click on finish, okay. Here we need to give that Spring Bean configuration file name, spring-servlet.xml we need to give. After that, just save it. Okay, save it. Just I am closing that web.xml file. After that, spring-servlet.xml file. This is a Spring Bean configuration file. First, I want to create one controller. Just go to resource, Java resources. Here there is no Java folder available, so just select the project, right click, new folder, and select the project src main. Here I want to place the Java folder. Just give the folder name as Java. Just click on finish. Here you can see the Java folder is coming outside Java, outside Java resources. Just select the project. Just refresh it. Now we got the Java folder inside Java resources. Just select the project. Give the package name. Just I am trying to give the package name as tk.learn-to-success. tk.learn-to-success. After that, just click on finish. Here I am trying to create one new controller class. So that just select the package, right click, new class. Give the class name. Here I am giving the class name as first controller. First controller I am giving. After that, just click on finish. Here the controller is nothing but in the servlet we will use any, if you want to call any class as servlet, that class must implement the servlet interface directly or indirectly. But in the same case, the controller also, if you want to call any class as controller, that class must implement the controller interface directly or indirectly. We need to write that implements implements controller. Just controller we need to write. After that, when you here it is showing an error, just place the cursor there, add unimplemented methods. Okay. I don't want to write any logic here, just I want to call that one JSP file I want to call, and I want to print the output. For that, what I am trying to do is just go to web deployed resources, select web app. I want to create a new folder for placing all the JSP files. Just create a folder. I want to create the folder name as some pages. I am trying to create pages. Just after that, click on finish. Here I want to transfer the control to the JSP. For that, new model and view. Here I am passing only that JSP file name 1. I am passing. I want to give the JSP file name as 1. Just now we are ready with the controller. but we want that 1.jsp now. So just select that pages folder available in the web app. Just select the folder, right click, new JSP. Give the JSP name as 1.jsp. Click on finish. I want to test whether the application is working or not. For that, so that's why I am writing a simple message, writing from 1.jsp. I am writing, just after that, just save it. Controller here, everything is ready, but we need to configure this controller in the first controller in the servlet-servlet.xml file. Before that, we need to configure one more bin, that is nothing but internal resource view resolver is a class. We need to configure it. First, the give ID. You can give any name. Here I am giving the ID name as JSP. You can give any name. After that, just class. Here we need to give the class name as internal resource view resolver. We need to configure. Okay, inside it has two properties, that is nothing but prefix and suffix. Just property prefix, give the prefix value as I want to access the JSP, so that's why /pages/. After that, I want to configure one more property, search for suffix and give the value .jsp. I am giving. After that, okay, now we are ready with that one bin. We want to configure that one more bin, that is nothing but first controller. We need to configure. Just control space bin, give ID. Here ID is nothing but that URL pattern we need to give. In order to access that first controller, I am giving that slash first I am giving. After that, we need to configure that class equal to first controller I am giving. Okay, now we are ready with the Spring Beam configuration file also. Just save it. Now we are ready with all the code. What I am trying to do is just I want to run it by using Tomcat server. Just go to the servers tab. Here there is no server is available. Just select the server, double click on it, just select your Tomcat. Tomcat, in my case it is Tomcat 9 is installed in my system, so that's why I am selecting Tomcat 9 version. Click on next. Just select the installation of your Tomcat server. Just in my case it is available in C drive, program files, Apache Tomcat. Just click on OK. Click on next. You need to add this project to the Tomcat server. After that, click on finish. Okay, now we are ready with the configuring the server also. Just what I am trying to do is just click on publish. Click on start. I am trying to start the server. It is saying that port number 8080 is required by Tomcat, but it is already in my case Oracle is using that 8080 port number. What I am trying to change the port number, just double click on the servers. Immediately you will get one configuration file. Just go to this http://11.1.1. Just give any port number. Here I am giving the port number as 888 I am giving. Just save it. Just go to servers, right click, start. I am trying to start the server. Here now we can see that server is trying to start. It takes some time to start. Okay, why is error? We got server port 80, we got some error. What I will do, just I want to delete that installation. C drive. Go to program file, Apache Tomcat, delete. I want to install new Tomcat, so that's why, so that we can solve that problem. In my case, all the softwares are available in the I think no software is Tomcat is not available. I will try to download from the internet. Tomcat download. Just go to Apache Tomcat. Tomcat 9. Select this zip folder. I am selecting this Windows. Windows I am selecting. Just select it. Not just select this Windows 64 zip. It is trying to download the Tomcat server. Taking some time to download. After that, we will just extract the Tomcat server and we will reconfigure. Meanwhile, what I am trying to do, just go to the Eclipse and go to the servers. Just remove this, delete. Okay. Now, no servers are available here in the project. Also, one servers is there. Just I am trying to delete it. Just delete it. Click on OK. Now no server is configured in my Eclipse. I think it is downloaded. It is downloaded. Just I want to open it. Still it is not downloaded, so it's taking time. Okay, now it is downloaded. Just I am trying to open that downloaded location. Just copy it. Go to C drive. Just paste here. After that, I am trying to extract the Tomcat server. Extract here. Click on OK. Just trying to extract the Tomcat. Okay, it's extracted. What I will do is just go to Eclipse. Just double click on the servers. Select the Tomcat version 9. After you can see that it is extracted, just go to Eclipse. Select the browse and go to the install location of your Tomcat. Tomcat 9. Click on OK. Click on Next. Add this project. Click on finish. We configured just what I am trying to publish. Start. I am trying to start the server. We got the same error, that is port 8080 is in use. I want to change the port number. Just go to here. Give the port number any number. Just save it. Just I'm trying to start the server. Just start. Now the server is started. Just go to console, check whether any errors are available or errors are there or not. There is no errors. What I will do is, again we got the same error. Why a chained container failed during start? just go there, go to server. The server, Tomcat server is stopped. I know why it's stopping. There is a small issue with my Tomcat server, so that's why I deleted that Tomcat server and I installed again, reinstalled, then now it's working fine. Let's check and run whether it's working or not. What I'm trying to do is just right click, start the server. Start the server, it is trying to start. Okay, it started. Now you can access it. If you want to access it, just go to browser and give the project name here. In my case, the project name is Spring Web MVC XML. Spring Web MVC XML / first. You can see that it's working from 1.js. Like this, we can test our Spring Web MVC project. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching.